Hey guys, so today I wanted to make a video to show you how to do a complete teardown and reassembly on the Motorola Luge XT907. If you're interested where I got this phone or where I got the parts to fix it, I'll include a link in the video description for that, and also where I got the tools to work on this, and anything that might be helpful to you, I'll put in the video description. So next, what we will need to do is, this is the same as the Droid Razor M as well. This Motorola Luge is the same as the Droid Razor M, and it's the XT907, as I said before, but so they're pretty much identical as far as repairs go. So I already removed these screws, but there's three screws on this side, on each side here. Wanted to show you, and it takes a Torx T5, sometimes a T4 if the T5 is a little bit tight. But and then what we're going to need to do is remove this front here. It's got adhesive on it, pretty strong adhesive, so we're going to hit it with just a little bit of heat. And then also under this Motorola logo on the front here, we're going to hit that with a little bit of heat as well and try prying it. So now I just use a regular hair dryer like this. That's all I have, just a cheap little hair dryer. And so I just hit it for a few seconds here on high and didn't want to show it because it's noisy. And then so I just take like a guitar pick type thing and slide it under here on the front. You can see it starting to crack there a little bit. And just go kind of carefully and wiggle it, and then once you get your fingernail under it, you can kind of just work it up. It's got kind of strong adhesive, but just make sure that it doesn't break or anything, and just slide it up kind of like that. Now you can see it has adhesive on it. But like some of this adhesive came off on this part and some of it stayed. Probably what I'll do is end up pulling this off and putting it on here. So now the next part, if you take your heat gun and apply a little bit of heat on here, I would say again 5 to 10 seconds at the most. You don't want to do too much at a time. And then what works really well is to take a little razor. I don't have one to show right here, but to take a little razor or something really sharp and get under here. Make sure not to scratch the top of this. What I ended up having to do is all I had was a tweezers that was fine enough. So I started under this corner right here. And I got it a little bit loose right now, so it comes off a little harder than what I'm showing right here because I got it loose, but I just wanted to show you what you have to do. And this part comes right off. You have to be careful not to bend this or anything, so you have to be able to put this back when you're all done. And then there's two screws under here, so those two have to come out and these three have to come out. So that will be the next step. So just for a quick overview, I wanted to go over that there's three screws on this side, three screws on this side, and there's two screws on the top here, and three screws on the bottom here, and they're all different size. Well, the ones on the sides are the same size, and then the ones on the top and the bottom are different, so you want to make sure to keep those separate. So next you will want to make sure, I should have mentioned this even sooner, but you want to make sure that there's no memory cards or SIM cards in the phone here. If there are, you will want to remove those. And then what you'll need to do is you can use a pry tool like this, or perhaps even this one here, the guitar pick, and you will want to start somewheres. I would say right here in the middle is a good spot, and you want to start separating this and just kind of work your way around. See how it's starting to separate? No problem. And now there's some little clips down here that you'll want to give extra attention to down here at the bottom. So there's a little plastic clip right here, and on this side that you'll want to watch, it comes apart a little bit hard right there, but just be careful. And then you want to now just watch when you're separating this that you have like a pry tool, something like that. I prefer a plastic one so it doesn't do any damage to any connectors. And you just want to reach in there and disconnect that connector, and then you got it apart. So to remove the logic board, what you'll need to do is remove some screws. There's these T5 screws. There's one, two here, and on this side there's one, two, three, and then there's one up in this corner here too that you gotta watch. He's tricky one. So there's six total. I already removed those, but just to show you that you need to do that. And then you need to remove the rear camera right here. You can do that just by prying up on this connector right here. And then, yeah, that comes right out. And then next, I would recommend just totally removing this. You can pop this connector too for the front camera here. And just pry up under this corner right here. And then just push this way, kind of twist it this way clockwise, and it comes right out. Some people say that you don't have to remove that, but it's a lot easier if you do that, and it doesn't take long at all. Then next, you'll need to pry up on this battery connector right here as well. Just pries up like this. And then what you need to do is pry up under this here, the bottom of the board right here. And now watch this. You can just kind of hold it there, but watch this battery connector here. Make sure that doesn't snag on anything. Then you can just pull that right up just like that. To change or remove the battery, what I would recommend is if you start right here where the SIM tray came out, the SIM card, and if you pry up, just have something flat like this so you can get under and pry up a little bit in this corner. And it comes up kind of hard. There's quite a bit of adhesive under it. And then what I would do is get started something in the middle further down with like this pick. And then you just keep working under there. And keep working that down. And then once you get to a certain point, you can get under the middle here. And then just be careful because it's got lots of adhesive under it. And then you can just pry it up carefully. And there you go. So to put it back in, what you'll need to do is notice where the up arrow is, and this part here was down, so you want to make sure to turn it the right way and put your new battery back in. Press down firmly, make sure the adhesive sticks well, and there you go. To reinstall the logic board, what you'll need to do is just set it right down in. Watch this battery flex cable. That's the main one to watch. Just make sure it's sitting down everywhere. And then there's this little piece here, this rubber piece that tends to like to fall off. It goes up here by the rear camera. And I just wanted to show you. It goes just around there where the connector is. Just make sure that that gets put back in if it falls out. So then go ahead and reconnect the battery. And then first put the front camera assembly back in before you do the rear camera one. It's easier that way. So you can just set it right down in here. Make sure it's pushed down properly. There's a connector on this side that needs to connect. And then you can put the rear camera back in. Just set it right down in its hole there. Make sure it's connected properly. And then put those six screws back in. Okay, so this next part's a little hard to show, but to reassemble the front screen, what you need to do is just set it here close by, and you can see this connector here, and you have to reconnect this connector right here. So it's a little bit tricky, but it's not too bad. You just have to line it up properly and then press it down. And then so next what we will need to do is to begin reassembly. I'll just watch all the way around, make sure everything's lining up properly. I would recommend getting these clips at the bottom here, these clips popped in first. And just make sure all the way around that everything is in properly. And then put your three screws back in the bottom here, the two on the top, and then put the three on each side. And you can make sure that this is squeezed together before you tighten your screws for the final time. Just make sure that that crack is nice and tight. And there you go. So next, after you have all your screws in the side, both sides, and then the two in the top and the three on the bottom. So next, what you want to do is put this thing in the top here, the Motorola piece where it says, yeah, Motorola, and put it up here for the earpiece speaker. Set it down nicely. And then next you'll want to take this part here. Now earlier I had mentioned about the adhesive, I ended up putting it on this part. And you'll want to just take and set that right on there. Make sure it clicks in nicely. And I think what I would do just so it for sure sets up nicely is give it just a little bit of heat here and there, and you're good to go. Then next, remember to put your SIM card back in, your memory card, if you have any of those. And then last but not least, try to power the phone up, make sure that it's going to work, and you're good to go. Thanks for watching.